Hello, I'm back with another makeup experiment, and today we're gonna go back to the 20s.
The inventions of the 1910s, such as mascara, lipstick, eyeshadows, pan sticks, and powder compacts, came to the 20s, and it was time for enhanced makeup. The popular foundation look was very pale, with plenty of rouge, lip color, and kohl eyeshadow.
For the foundation, I'm gonna use Revlon Color Stay Today. Their skin had to be very fair. They used powders one or two shades lighter than their own skin. And the undertone of the powders was always pink and never yellow. Their brows.
Oh no.
The highest point of the brow had to be here. And then it drops down here. Was like this, literally. It had to be very thin, so they either plucked them out or they just shaved it off. So I'm taking just a regular razor, like Gillette. And I'm just very carefully start shaving them off.
Just kidding.
The eyes.
Black grease pencil was smudged around the eye socket to create a deep-set eyes effect. The eyelid was often painted in gray. Besides gray, colors like turquoise, green, and blue were also in fashion.
I'm gonna take my Maybelline shadow pencil. It's very black and it's easy to do smoky eye with it because it blends very good. They line the eyes all the way around. Okay. So now I'm gonna blend it. I'm gonna use just a random gray eyeshadow, which I bought in a Sally Beauty Supply. So I'm gonna blend it also here. It looks good. I'm gonna make it a little bit darker, so I'm taking black eyeshadow. Just matte black. And I'm gonna add it here. Each wonderful night in Tunisia, where the nights are filled with peace. Notice the same moon above you, a glow with its cool evening light, but shining at night in Tunisia. Also, I know that they used white pencil on the waterline to enhance their eyes, to make them bigger. That scares me. The lashes had to be massive. First, I'm gonna use one white coat. And the mascara I'm gonna use is Scandalize Retro Glam by Rimmel. So now the lips.
Lips were smaller than the natural outline and fashioned into the Cupid's bow shape. They slightly exaggerated the lips in the middle. And the colors of the lips were from dark red to orange.
First, I'll put some concealer on my lips. I'm gonna use that Bordeaux color. Like this. I'll add some dark red color. It's from Cotton, one of the four lip crayons, which I just adore. They're matte and the colors are beautiful. Do you know why I'm so happy now? Because it's not my everyday makeup tutorial. The colors of the blush they used were orange or red.
And later, rose and raspberry became very fashionable.
I'm gonna use Fun Cotton Lip Crayon, more like warm red color. My foundation brush. They applied blush right in the middle, in the shape of a circle. That's awesome. now the brows, then I will be too shy to sit in front of the camera.
Should I do it or should I not do it? Should I do it?
I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna take just a black pencil. And they would prolong them. How can I make a beautiful picture out of that? I don't know. And I think I'm done. I glow with its cool evening light, but shining at night in Tunisia, never does it shine so bright. The stars are aglow in the heavens. Alright, so thank you very much, and I'll see you soon. Bye! Shining at night in Tunisia, they guide you through the desert sea. To tell a tale, too exotic to be told. Each night's a deeper night.